Hi students, welcome to new chapter Force and Motion. This is the second lesson in science. Come, let's see the objective. Objective means you know that what are the topics you are going to learn in this lesson. So here we are going to learn push and pull, involved in motion, contact and non-contact forces. When a force is applied, how it moves the object, change the direction of travel, then change shape and size of the object, difference between rest and motion and how they are related, application of force, types of motion, definition of average speed, unit of speed, uniform and non-uniform motion, and last one is time, distance and speed. First one is push and pull. So what is push? When a force is applied to make an object to move far from us is called push. When we push an object, it moves away from us. Then pull. We know it is the opposite of push. That is, when a force is applied, the object moves towards us is called pull. When we pull an object, it moves closer to us. Next one is motion and rest. When an object is not moved from its place, we say it is in rest. When a book is in the same place with respect to table, then we can say that book is at rest. We have seen a lot of examples in real life which does not move from its place, like house, electric post, etc. Next is motion. We can consider that same book. If a force is applied to move the book from the table or when it is carried to the school, then we can say that the book is in motion. So real life example of motion is birds flying, playing with ball, etc. Now rest and motion are relative. It can be explained with an example. Here the girl is riding her bicycle to her grandmother's home. So there are two factors in this. First one is the girl on bicycle with respect to road, and second is the girl with respect to bicycle. First factor is that the girl is in motion, that is she is moving with respect to the road. Second factor is that the girl is stationary, or she is in rest with respect to bicycle. She is not moving anywhere in the cycle. She is stationary with the cycle. So with this we can conclude that rest and motion are relative. How things move? So we already know that the object moves when a force is applied. This force can be push or pull. So the motion occur when the object is pushed or pulled by a force. Next one is contact and non-contact forces. Contact means we all know that when we touch is called contact. Here when a force is applied by touching the object is called contact force. And non-contact force is just the opposite, that when we are not touching the object. So when a force is applied by not touching the object is called non-contact forces. So example of contact force is kicking a ball, pushing a stroller, etc. And example of non-contact force is magnetic force, where the magnet attracts the iron nails without touching them. Now we are going to see when we apply a force, what will happen to the object. First thing is, when we apply force, it changes its state from rest to motion or from motion to rest. So example is kicking a ball. That is, it changes from rest to motion, and stopping a bicycle. This is an example for stopping a motion to rest. Second one, when we apply force, it will change the speed or direction or maybe both of the object. Example is batting. That is, when a bowler throws a ball in one direction with some speed, the batsman strikes the ball which changes its direction and also speed of the ball. Third one is, when a force is applied, it changes the shape and size of the object. So for this, the example is squeezing a ball or making laddus. Last topic of this video is types of motion. There are different types of motion. They are rotational motion. So example for rotational motion is fan, because it rotates in its axis. Next one, circular motion. So example is pencil in a compass. So it moves in a circular path. So the motion involved is circular. Linear motion. Example is drawing a line. So it is about a straight line. Oscillatory movement. For this, the example is pendulum. It moves to and fro, that is move forward and backward. Then periodic motion. Periodic means it moves in a regular interval. Example is clock, because for every 5 minutes the minute hand moves exactly one number in the clock. Non-periodic motion. So it means it moves in different time period with different speed or force. Example is swing. Here we can make the swing move faster for some period and move slower for some period. So it comes under non-periodic motion. So we have come to the end of this video. The remaining topic is in the next video. Thank you.